Next question is from Warrior Monk Fitness. Is following your passion bad advice?
You know, I love these broad like recommendations or, you know, wisdom where they're like, follow your passion.
How many times have you heard that statement on Instagram?
You know, I think you're in trouble if you always follow your feelings or if you always follow your mind. I think you have to be able to do both.
Yeah.
Always following your passion, you'll be chasing your feelings around all the time.
Because it'll change too.
And you may not be pragmatic. You may end up dating the wrong person because you're passionate about them. You may end up doing a job that doesn't really support you or your family very well because you're not being pragmatic. Your diet may be passion driven, in which case you may not eat in the right way. Your workouts might be the wrong workouts. I think passion and emotion are important. It's part of what makes us human. But just following passion, I don't think that's a great message.
I didn't think you guys were going to go this direction. I thought I was going to be the one that was going to challenge that. I thought you guys were going to be all pro, go for your passion. But
we're all wise.
You know, I guess. That show I was talking to about the playbook, one of the coaches kind of like alluded to this and said, you know, doing things like that, you're driven by your feelings. Mm-hmm. And it isn't always the most logical decision. You know, sometimes you feel passionate about something because it makes you find it's fun or you enjoy it, or currently at this moment in your life, you have a feeling around it, and it's that feeling that drives that passion, and that may not always drive a logical decision in what you should be doing. And so actually being able to, and it's not also necessarily a bad thing either, because you know, hopefully whatever it is that you end up doing for the rest of your life, you're also passionate about.
It may be the spark that got you there.
Right, but I know there's a lot of things in my life that I'm very passionate about today that I fell into because I was just open to doing a bunch of other things. And so, and I think that this message for the generation kind of coming up now, being somebody who has had, you know, now what, 2-3 generations that I've led underneath me, and seeing like the you know, Gen Z and
millennials
millennials coming up and how this is like a very hot topic, like finding something that they're so passionate about, and some of them spend so much time trying to find this passion
that they'll turn other things, opportunities away.
Right.
Yeah, that's what I'm seeing.
They don't do something. And part of that is like just getting yourself. And I mean, look, I did not actually love personal training that much. Like, I liked personal training. I really did. Like, but what I found in it was other things that I ended up really being passionate about. Like, I was passionate about building a business. I liked numbers. I liked sales. I didn't even know that was part of that, but I found out that it was a big part of it, which made me more passionate and fell in love with it. And then I got into leading trainers and thought, oh my God, I don't like personal training at all. I love leading trainers. And so sometimes you don't know if it's going to be something that you're going to be really passionate about. So turning away a lot of things because you're like, oh, I'm not really passionate about that. I don't feel very passionate about it. And so you don't do it. I think that's a silly way to live your life.
Yeah, I think it's important to definitely don't turn away opportunities. Get involved in these opportunities and find where that passion lies within that experience. And, you know, for me, it took a while to kind of figure that out, like what I really wanted to do. You know, I did a lot of different types of jobs, and it definitely eliminated a lot of directions that I thought I wanted to go in. But I was like, well, I don't like this industry. I'm not really, you know, driven towards this. That other job I had, you know, there was a spark there. And so, you know, in terms of like just waiting for that passion, you know, to present itself for you, I think that's not the message I would put out there.
I think if you're seeking to have passion for something that's going to serve you for the rest of your life, I would say find passion in growth. Okay. Because that'll always serve you.
Yeah.
No matter what happens in your life, if you're passionate about growth, it means you're going to embrace challenge. It means that you'll view failure, which you will encounter in your life a lot. You'll view failure as a learning and growth process. I think that's a very smart way to look at things. I think if you run by passion on specific things, you're going to screw yourself. And, you know, to your point, Adam, about, you know, these generations coming up and having to find their passion, that's the result of a wealthy, easy, good society. I know some people are getting their feelings hurt right now because they think, oh, life is so tough or whatever. Okay, I'm talking about in comparison to how it's always been for people. Okay, go back to your parents, your grandparents, your great grandparents. Yeah. you know, my great grandfather didn't find a job that he was passionate about, you know? he did it because
he had to fight tooth and nail for an opportunity.
Also, here's the deal. Passion, happiness, excitement, they feel great. They're wonderful, but that's not the key to success in life. The key to success in life is meaning, purpose. Those will always serve you. You know, they do these surveys of people who have children, and they compare them to people who don't have children. And it's so funny when these when articles are written about this. But you could tell there's a media bias constantly trying to convince people to not have children, because you'll read the article titles and they'll say things like, people, you know, couples who don't have kids are more happy. People who don't have kids have more fun. And so if you just read the headline, you're like, wow, I'm not going to have any kids because people who don't have kids have less stress and they're more happy. Yes, that's true, but continue to read the study. People who have kids find more purpose and meaning in their life. Mm-hmm. Which one is more valuable? Ask any old person who's about to die or who's reaching the end of their life, and they'll tell you it's meaning and purpose. So passion, excitement, happiness.
Those are all fleeting.
Yeah. They're great. Enjoy them. They're real parts of life. But that's not what life is all about. So although passion is a part of who you are and you should experience it, don't chase it and drive after it and make that your defining feeling, because you'll be screwed. I promise you. You'll be fleeting. And I've worked with lots of people like this. I have worked with very talented people who were constantly chasing passion. And when they're young, it's okay. Oh, I'm moving from this thing. I'm doing this thing. I'm passionate. I'm bored. Yeah. And now that they're in their 30s and 40s, they're not successful. Mm-hmm. They're in debt.
Not happy.
They're always looking for the next thing.
Always looking for the next thing. So,
well, you know what ends up happening is that you're something that you're so passionate about, you end up working in that industry, and then you would find out there's so much more to it.
Right.
And then all of a sudden that passion starts to fade away, and then now you're stuck in this career that you waited so long to get into because you thought you had to be so passionate about it, and then that all changes.
It's always greener somewhere else.
Here's a great example. Talk to any successful couple that's been together for 40, 50, 60 years, right? Talk to them about passion. When you first meet someone, you fall in love with them.
Yep.
Passion dominates the relationship. It's just all over the place. But how do you build a long-lasting partnership with the person? Those feelings change and go away, and then you have this bond that is different than passion, but way stronger and more powerful. And that's much more important. If you're always chasing passion, here's what will end up happening. You'll fall in love with someone. You become passionate. Passion starts to wane. Then you don't give the bonding a chance. You don't give the hard part, the part that's real important, a chance. You end up leaving them. You go to the next person you feel passionate about. And that's it's a road to failure. It's a road to a poor outcome in life. So passion is good, but don't let that
rule
over.
Don't lean on it.
Absolutely.